Today, we are going to do an activity that is called a traffic light. And this is one of the most exciting and little bit complex activity. As every one of us know about a traffic light. So in traffic light, we have three different colors light, red, yellow, and green. Red stands for stop, yellow means wait, green means go. So in this activity, we are going to make our own manual traffic light with the help of a material available in your kit. In this activity, we need LEDs. So this type of LEDs we need in this activity. We have three different type of LEDs, red, yellow, and green. We need one base, battery, four wires, one resistor, metallic key, screws, screwdriver, and a battery cap. Before proceeding for this activity, let me tell you more about the components we are going to use in this activity, as we have to use the components very carefully in this activity. Let me tell you more about LED. So this small device is called LED. LED means light emitting diode. Yes, the full form of LED is light emitting diode. So LED is a two terminal device. So here you can see we have two legs or two terminals of LED. The bigger one is positive terminal and the smaller one is negative terminal. You have to remember this, the bigger one is positive terminal and the smaller one is negative terminal. So we have a different type of LEDs. We have red, yellow, and green LEDs in this activity. In addition to that, we have to use a battery cap. So battery cap is a two terminal device. The red one is positive and the black one is negative. And we have one battery cap or battery. This is a 9 volt battery. We have two terminal, positive and negative. And we have few wires. And one of the most important thing in this activity is this green color device. This is a two terminal device and we call it resistor. This is a resistor. This is a two terminal device, but in resistor we don't have any positive or negative terminal. Yes, remember this, we don't have positive or negative terminal in resistor. This is called a resistor. Resistor is a device which is used to obstruct the flow of current. Sometimes we need a lesser amount of current, so this small device will obstruct the flow of higher amount of current. That is called a resistor. And one most important thing, never use this LED directly with 9 volt battery, because the current or the voltage inside this battery is very high, and as a result, if we connect directly this LED with the 9 volt battery, your LED will be fused. So never use this LED directly with a 9 volt battery. So that's why we have this device. So we have to use this device that is called resistor along with LED in order to protect our LED from fuse. That's why we are using this green color device that is called a resistor. And we have a different type of a resistors, and each resistor is having a different value depending upon the applications. We have different type of a resistors, and the SI unit or the standard unit of resistor is ohms, OHM ohms. That is the standard unit of resistor. These resistor we are also using in our mobile phones, in laptops, at various electronics appliances. We are using the resistor because this resistor controls the flow of current. That's why we are using this resistor at many places. So this is the one of the most important component we have in this activity. Now let's start and make this activity that is called a traffic light. So you have to remove all the parts. So we have to take this part firstly. And we have to put the red LED first and make sure the positive terminal or the bigger leg at the left side. You have to put at the left side, that is the bigger terminal at left side, or the positive at left and then active at right. So like this, you have to put the red LED, and at the back side you have to bend both the terminals like this. Similarly, we have to put the yellow, the bigger one, or the positive terminal at left, or the negative terminal at right. And again, you have to bend it like this. And then similarly, the green one, the positive at the left, or the negative at the right. In this way, I have put it all the three LEDs, red, yellow, and green. And at all the three LEDs, my positive at the left and the negative at the right. Make sure all the positive must be at left and negative must be at right. Now, the next step is that I have to connect all the negative terminal of these LEDs together. So these are the negative terminals of these LEDs. We have to connect all the three negative terminals, that is the smaller legs, together. So how you have to connect it? Either you connect it together, right? You can connect it together like this. The first one and the second one, you have to connect like this, and you have to bend it like this. Like this. And for third one, you have to take one extra wire. So you have one extra wire in your kit. So this is a small extra wire you have. So you have to use this peeled extra wire. And here you can see how you have to connect all the three negative terminal together. So you have to put it like this and make a connection like this. And you have to connect it with the third negative terminal like this. And if you are facing any problem, then you can take help from your parents or from your elder one. Okay. So in this way, I have made the connection here. Means all the three negative terminals I have connected together. Here you can see. All the three negative terminals I have connected together. Now the next step is that you have to take one red wire, any one red wire you can take, and it must have, and both the terminal must be peeled. And now you have to connect the one end of this wire with this joint where we have connected all the three wires, all the three negative terminals. So in this way, you have to connect it one red wire with these three points, and make sure all the three points or this wire must be connected carefully and tightly. So in this way, we have connect all the negative terminals of the LED together, and I have connected one red wire with these three points. In this way, you have made the connections. Now, the next step is that we have three positive terminals, red, yellow, and green. These are the three positive terminals of three LEDs. Now, we have three wires. So, you have to connect the positive terminal of red LED with the first, like this, with the wire. In this way, you have to make connections. Then similarly, you have to make connection for the red, yellow, and green. I have made this for red. Then similarly for yellow. In this way, you have to make the connection for yellow. And then for green. So I have made the connection for red, yellow, and green. I have connected the three wires with a positive terminal of red, yellow and green. Now the next step is that we have to use screws, and we have three points, red, yellow and green, and we have to put the screws here with the help of a screwdriver. You can tighten it little bit firstly. Red, yellow, and green. Like this. Now the next step is that you have to put the structure like this, and this red one, the wire which is coming from the positive terminal of red, you have to connect with the red screw like this, and you can tighten it and the next yellow one you have to connect it like this and then tighten it. And then the green one, you have to, let me show you, you have to connect it like this and then tighten it. In this way we have connected the red, yellow and green. Now the most important component, that is your resistor. So you have to connect the resistor with an active terminal of your this wire. So you have to connect the any one terminal of your resistor with this wire piece like this. Like this you have to connect the resistor. And then you have to connect the negative terminal of your battery cap. So this is your battery cap with an active terminal. So you have to connect the negative terminal with the second terminal of resistor like this. And at last we have to use a switch. So we have a switch and one more screw, you have to use it here and tighten it, and you have to connect the positive terminal here like this in this, and then tighten the screw. In this way we have completed the circuit for traffic light. And I know this is little bit complex structure or a complex circuit, but in this way you can learn how to make the complex circuits, and that's why this circuit is very very much important, because in the circuit we have used the LEDs, we have used resistor, we have used battery caps, screws, switch, all these things we have used in this activity. Now the next step is that we have to connect the battery. Battery is very important in all the electronics experiments. So here I have connected the battery. Now still the circuit is not working because we have to use this key or a switch. When I touch it with the red screw, immediately the red LED start glowing. And when I touch with the yellow, yellow LED start glowing, and similarly with the green. So in this way you can make your own traffic light. When you touch it with the green color screw, immediately the green LED start, because this is the case of a closed circuit, and in closed circuit the circuit is completed, the flow of electron take place, as a result the LED is glowing. And this is the case of open circuit, right now the circuit is open, so that there is no flow of current, as a result the LED is not glowing. Similarly with yellow and green. So in this way you have made your own manual traffic light, and you have learned the concept of LEDs, how to use the LEDs, what is the positive and negative terminal of LED, what is a resistor, why we are using resistors in these activities, the concept of positive and negative connections. So all these things we have learned from this activity, and the science behind this activity is open circuit and closed circuit. Open circuit means when there is no flow of current. The closed circuit means when there is a flow of current. So in this way, we have completed our traffic light activity.